this is Debbie from Lame Duda Design, and today for Spellbinders I'm going to be making a wreath card. I do love a classic wreath, and I'm combining the wreath with my love for watercolours and watercolouring card to use when die cutting. The products I'm using today are wreath, little plants, wreath elements, flower power, fray set 1 and A2 matting basics B dies. I'll also be using the platinum 6 die cutting machine, the magnetic handy mat and the 2-in-1. Starting with the platinum 6 die cutting machine, and this is my first time using this machine, so I thought I would share a quick unboxing video. When you open the box you get a package of plates and instructions as well as the handle. The machine is packaged in sturdy cardboard so it's well protected. I open the instruction manual to ensure I attach the handle correctly. The setup is very quick and easy to follow, and within a couple of minutes my platinum 6 die cutting machine was set up and ready for use. I like the fact that the base plate has visual instructions for different sandwiches, that all the cutting mats and embossing accessories are included too, and that the machine is stylish and its white colour will fit into anyone's craft space. I also like the fact that the base of the machine folds up, so when not in use its footing takes up less space. One final detail to mention are the rubberized feet on the base of the machine, which will prevent it scratching a surface it is placed on and also keeps the machine sturdy in place when using it. I had a plan in mind for creating this wreath card, and so I gathered together the dies that I thought I'd use. However, before commencing with the die cutting, I first want to prepare two watercolour panels. I used 3M blue painter's tape to attach a piece of Archer's cold press watercolour card to a piece of board, and this will help prevent the card warping as I add the watercolours. I added a few layers of different green toned watercolour, roughly painting each layer before drying and moving on to the next layer. I then splattered the panel with paint and also with white gouache. All these layers and splatters resulted in a watercolour panel with lots of colour variation and texture. I repeated the watercolouring for a second panel, this time in pinky peach tones. Again I used a few layers of watercolour and then splattered with paint and white gouache. However, this time I also splattered with a solution of perfect pearls to give the flowers some sparkle. I started die cutting the wreath die from more of the watercolour card. I like to use the same card throughout my project so that the colours match, and also watercolour card is thickened so nice and sturdy. I followed the instructions on the base plate to construct the die cutting sandwich and then ran the die through the Platinum 6 machine. At first I had the machine on my mat, however although the machine stayed on the mat was slipping on the table, so I removed that and then used the machine straight onto my desk where it was able to stay in place. I used the brush from the 2-in-1 to help me remove the intricate die cut from the die, and then used the pointed end to push out the negative areas of the die cut to reveal the beautiful wreath. I also cut the largest A2 matting basics B die from the watercolour card. Next I used 3 of the little plants dies and ran them through the platinum 6 with the green watercolour panel. I ran the little plant dies through again to get a nice selection of leaves for the wreath, and then moved on to die cutting the flowers. I used 2 of the flower power dies and ran those through with the pink watercolour card. I planned on layering the smaller on top of the larger flower. I also die cut more flowers using the wreath elements dies, and for these flowers I chose to add extra dimension and interest to the die cuts by running them back through the platinum 6, but this time with the embossing mat and plate. I followed the instructions on the base plate again and got great results first time. I roughly planned out where I wanted all the elements to sit on the card and then worked on how to attach them. I started by gluing the smaller of the flower power dies on top of the larger one. I then added foam adhesive to the back of all the other leaves and flowers. I removed the backing paper from the foam adhesive and then laid the elements gently in place on the wreath. I'm not trying at this point to attach the elements to the background, but just the wreath. Once all the flowers and leaves were attached to the wreath, then I had a larger area on the back where I could hide foam adhesive so that it wouldn't be visible from the front. I did add some tiny pieces of foam adhesive to the lower left of the wreath so that area would be supported too. Before adding the wreath to the background panel though, I mixed up some fine tech moon gold paint and splattered that over the panel to add just a touch of interest to the background. I dried that with a heat tool and then laid the wreath down on top. I tied a long loopy twine bow and attached that to the wreath also. For the sentiment, I die cut a happy birthday from slate card using the fray set 1 dies, and then added that to the wreath with tiny pieces of foam adhesive. I added foam adhesive to the background panel and then added that to a fog card base. For the centre of the flowers I squeezed Nouveau Crystal Drops in the Ivory Seashell colour. I also dotted around the wreath droplets of Bubblegum Blush Crystal Drops, and then for the final accent added a few Sweet Shop sequins. And that completes this watercolour die cut wreath card. I like that the wreath is cut from a pale card so that you get the impression of a wreath but without the wreath dominating. This way the watercoloured flowers and leaves become the main focus of the card. The supplies I used today will be noted in the video description below, where you will also find a link to the coordinating blog post. If you want to find me, I blog over at lamdudadesign.com. I want to thank you for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.